A lot of people enjoyed Bloodborne, so much so that they're still playing it to this day, myself included. And naturally, when you love something, you want more of it, much, much more. And so a lot of people have been asking whether or not we will get a follow-up to the wildly successful Bloodborne that, of course, launched in 2015 as a PS4 exclusive. Now, I'm one of these people. I'm one of these people that really wants a sequel, really wants a follow-up, but that doesn't mean that we can look into unrealistic leaks or just assume stuff. So I started looking into it and I dug through all sorts of interviews and news articles and publications and quote-unquote leaks from all over the net, and I found four main instances of credible information that will help answer this question definitively, at least as of mid-May 2017. Now, it's very possible that you're watching this in the future. It was announced at E3 and it's a moot point. But as of right now, this is what we know. And I'm going to go through each of these points now. Our first point comes from the Japanese gaming journal 4Gamer. Now, essentially what happened is they held an AMA-style event where they hosted all sorts of different gaming developers from all around the world, all different companies, publishers, creeds, types of gaming, whether it's mobile, console, or PC, they covered it all. And two of the people that they hosted were, at least at the time of this interview, employed with From Software specifically, and were people who had worked on Bloodborne just before this happened. Now, they said a lot of stuff in this interview. Most of it was not very crucial to Bloodborne specifically. It was mostly about design philosophy and work ethic, those types of things. But what they did say is that the activity, at least in the sect of From Software that developed Bloodborne, the same exact team, the same people, those people continued work right after Bloodborne wrapped up, both on the DLC and the complete game. Once they finished development, they kept working on some new title. So it didn't shut down. They didn't redistribute it to some other team. They began work on a new game. And this is significant because a lot of these gaming publishers, for instance, look at what just happened with Mass Effect Andromeda. What happened with Mass Effect Andromeda is BioWare's teams were completely reorganized and redistributed. They were broken down and moved to other places within the overall corporate structure of their parent companies. And so the team was basically split up. They didn't begin working immediately on the next Mass Effect game. What's significant about this is that that didn't happen. They weren't moved to development on Dark Souls 3. They weren't moved to development on Ashes of Ariandel or the Ringed City DLC. They stayed with their same people that they'd been working on, or working with rather, for years, and began working on a new title. That's significant. And furthermore, they made even more news. They made even bigger headlines. And they said, quote, one man in particular, one of those two, said, quote, 2017 will be a fruitful year for gamers. End quote. And he also said that the new title is very, very ambitious. Now, that gets a lot of people excited. Now, of course, they're looking at it. The average person is looking at this and saying, well, he said 2017 will be a fruitful year for gamers. He wouldn't have said that if the game were releasing in 2018. It wouldn't make much sense to say, yes, 2017 will be a very fruitful year for gamers. We're releasing in 2018. It wouldn't make any sense. So people took that as a heavy implication of a release in 2017 of whatever game that team is working on. Now, it's not specifically stated or explicitly specified that they are working on a follow-up to Bloodborne. It's very possible they could be following up with a quote-unquote spiritual successor to Bloodborne, some games in another setting, perhaps a different IP entirely, but that employs the same combat system. That's very, very possible, and it's something we'll discuss a little bit later, but I just want to get that out there. Our second point is a leaked slide from 2016. Now, this at first was thought to be completely fake, but it was later confirmed by various sources to be legitimate. Essentially, this slide that you're seeing on screen was used in some sort of managerial meeting where they went around and kind of explained their plans for their future releases. This is internal to From Software. Now, what's significant about this is that they say that the game, whatever this unannounced title is set to release in 2017. Now, that follows with what the previous point discussed, which was 2017 would be another year for another release. From Software has done this annual release thing with, for instance, Bloodborne in 2015, Dark Souls 3 in 2016, Dark Souls 2 before both of those. They've done this annualized thing, so it would make sense that they would at least have some game lined up for 2017. But the big thing and important thing about this slide is that it specifies that this is going to be a multi-platform game, a multi-platform title, specifically on the PS4, Xbox One, PC, and PSVR. Now, this is what gets most Bloodborne fans a little nervous, and that's because Sony signed exclusive rights to the Bloodborne franchise, specifically to that at least initial IP. Now, it's not clear if perhaps From had some sort of legal jiu-jitsu move that they had planned out in case the game was successful, where they could get out of an exclusive deal with Sony and could release Bloodborne 2 on all consoles and PC. It's possible that they did that. Sony has said multiple times that they did not expect Bloodborne to be anywhere near as successful as it ended up being, so perhaps they got lazy and left that open, but it's highly, highly unlikely, especially when you're dealing with a company as large as Sony. It's incredibly unlikely that they would leave any wiggle room to potentially lose out on a wildly successful potential franchise. So that, to me, would stand to reason that whatever this game in 2017 is, does not follow specifically the Bloodborne IP. Which, again, as we go through this, you'll see more and more. I think it stands to reason more than anything that From Software is developing a new IP, but are taking everything they've learned from Dark Souls 3 and Bloodborne and moving it into this new IP that they can release on all systems, on all consoles, and specifically even PSVR, as they specified on this slide. But we'll go into all of that in more detail with our next point. Speaking of which, coming from Hidetaki Miyazaki, who is the creative director and essentially the brains behind Dark Souls 1, Dark Souls 3, and Bloodborne. He's a very smart guy, and he is the powerhouse behind these games. Now, he has offered many contradicting points of view and many contradicting statements on Dark Souls, on whether or not there will be another one, on whether or not he will lead development on the next one. It's very, very fugazi and hard to figure out what he actually believes. Everything he touches seems to work, and fans of these franchises really seem to enjoy everything that he touches. Dark Souls 2 is by many considered to be a low point in the series, and that was a game that he did not help with, specifically because he was developing Bloodborne at the time, a game that, of course, was received much better than Dark Souls 2. So, it's very important what he says about this. He created Bloodborne. If anybody has a say in whether or not it will get a sequel, I'm sure it's Hidetaki Miyazaki. Now, he specified at the Tokyo Game Show that currently From Software, his company, is working on three titles. One, he outright completely disclosed, he said it is an Armored Core game. It's an entry into their mech franchise. This franchise is incredibly popular in Japan specifically. It's not super popular in the US or elsewhere, but in Japan it's very, very successful. It's something that's never really appealed to me, but nonetheless, some people really seem to enjoy it. So that's one game that they're working on right now. The second one that he said they're working on is one that, quote, falls in line with fan expectations, end quote. Why is that significant? Well, because fans would probably expect another Bloodborne. So many people take this as meaning that another Bloodborne is due and they're working on that. That's possible, certainly, but when we take into consideration the other previous points, my guess is that it means a Bloodborne-esque game, a Dark Souls-esque game, but potentially a new IP altogether. And he went on to say that their third game, a game that is also unannounced, is, quote, weird. And when people see it, they will be asking, what is this weird game that Miyazaki has made? End quote. Now, if Hidetaki Miyazaki thinks that a game is weird or will be perceived as strange, you know that that's significant. This is the guy that created Dark Souls and Bloodborne. Like, this guy, when he says something is weird, you know that it's probably really, really weird. So it's not clear which he's talking about. If he's saying that the weird game is going to be the one that releases in 2017, or maybe the second game, the one that falls more in line with fan expectations, is the 2017 title. That's very possible too. It's not stated here, but it was such an important factor that I thought I'd mention it. And lastly, and possibly most importantly, is that Hidetaka Miyazaki, the same guy that we were just talking about, he specified in an interview recently that after the studio being From Software, finished work on Dark Souls 3, they shifted all their work to a, quote, new IP, end quote. Now, again, this is all very, very fugazi. It's hard to tell what he's referring to specifically. Is he referring just to the group of people that were working on Dark Souls 3 and the DLC that they moved to a new IP? Is it the same IP that possibly the Bloodborne team was working on? Or is it a different one entirely? Again, it's very, very foggy. It's hard to tell what they're referring to, what they're talking about. But when we look at all of this together, all these four points, the fact that Bloodborne team members said that the game that they're working on is very ambitious and that 2017 will be fruitful for gamers. That says 2017, good release window. The leaked slide that we talked about, that says the game is set to release in 2017 as well. That jives with what we earlier heard in the first point, but it's a multi-platform, which probably in all likelihood means it's not Bloodborne. It's a new IP altogether. The Tokyo Game Show, when Miyazaki was interviewed, implies that there will be a game that falls in line with fan expectations, but there will also be one that's very, very weird. And he said 2017 is a good timeline or a good rough time to expect to hear something new from the company. And of course, lastly, the fact that Miyazaki clarified and said that they moved their team, their entire team, to development on a new IP. So what does all this mean? What do I think it means? Well, I've said multiple times when people have asked me on live streams, for instance, or on Twitter or on the Discord, people have asked me, do I think there will be a new Bloodborne? And I've said, absolutely. Sony's not allergic to money. Bandai Namco, From Software, they're not allergic to money. Of course, they'll make a new one. And I still think that they eventually will. My guess is just that that's not what they're working on right now. My personal expectation is that at E3 this year, they're going to announce a new IP entirely that is cross-platform, that's on PS4, Xbox One, PC, and even PSVR, however that would work. And it's going to be a new IP. It's going to take a lot from Dark Souls, from Bloodborne. It's going to wow everyone. It's going to be some new setting entirely, other than the sort of fantasy, sort of Victorian England setting. They're going to really flex their development muscles, and I'm really excited for that. Now, that is, of course, just speculation. That's based on the interviews, the countless interviews I've read in preparation for this video, of course, but that's my personal expectation. And then I would expect maybe in 2018, early 2018, we see a Bloodborne 2 released to help combat the Xbox One Scorpio, which I think will certainly happen. It's possible that they could announce both, even. They show a cinematic trailer for Bloodborne 2 and announce a new IP. That's possible too. Sony is going to be looking for any way to combat Xbox's newfound energy, specifically with regard to the Scorpio. And I think one of the main ways that they're going to do that is with lots and lots of exclusives, including potentially just even announcing that they're working on Bloodborne 2. Maybe they bring Miyazaki out, pay him $1 million to just say, yes, we're working on it. It'll be out next year. I think that's very possible too. We will eventually get a Bloodborne 2. There's no way it wouldn't happen. The publisher owns the IP. Sony owns the IP, probably jointly, though it's not clear. And as a result, they want money. They want those big bucks, and Lord knows Bloodborne 2 would sell like hotcakes. And so they will eventually make one. It's just a matter of when. And my personal prediction is that we won't get Bloodborne 2 until 2018. at the earliest. But that's just my estimation. Let me know your thoughts down below. Thank you for watching. If you're interested in joining the Discord, make sure to check that link out down below. We have a great time over there. And I do also share Steam keys, copies of games. We have jokes, an entire tab for jokes, memes, videos, music, everything. We have a great time over there. Plus, it's a great way to interact with me directly and other members of this community. But with all that said, thank you for watching, guys. If you liked the video, hit that like button. It really does help me out. And if you haven't already, consider subscribing. I'd really, really appreciate it. But thank you for watching. Love you all. Peace out.